Welcome back to the channel, welcome back to Mancbuses. If you're new here, this is the 1998 Dennis Dart. If you've already been with us before, well, you know exactly what this junk is. Today's job is the engine mount. We've got three brand new mounts after we discovered that one mount had gone, and then we discovered the other mount had gone, and then we discovered the last one had gone. So now we're doing them all, and then today we just discovered the exhaust mounts have also gone. So we've got a lot of mounts to do.
Exhaust is time to do it.
Not a lot of time to do it. We're building up now for the 6th of August, so we're going to crack this one off. We do actually have a cameraman today. Stefan is the other director who's behind the camera. So it's a full team of directors today.
Thanks, change.
It does. During this video, I think I'm going to make it a little bit more interesting as well. I think we're going to have a discussion about the cost of bus preservation.
Why?
Is there a bell on the other side of it?
There's not on the other side, there's just spinning.
Well, we're going to need a 24 spanner then, aren't we?
It's 22 anyway, that one. That's 22, we're going to get 22 now, that's it. So,
so I think the discussion is going to be the cost of bus, because we did want to look for when you bought and buy a new bus. I think this is the appropriate time to discuss how much this actually costs.
Too much.
I'd laugh if that just popped in my head. Dink!
I wouldn't.
No, I was going to say I wouldn't.
No, but we would.
This just feels like it's
well, if it snaps, it snaps. At least it's out.
Yeah, but we're going to 22 things, aren't
we? Yeah, we can tackle that at some point. I don't get one, and it doesn't matter. You get another one later.
Go on then. It can snap on you.
That always snaps.
It's turning, isn't
it? Yeah, it is just turning, isn't it?
It's turning.
Guess what?
Turns. No, it does. Right, we can get this out, lift the engine up.
Yeah, the cost of bus preservation, these two mounts. Yeah, so these engine mounts.
That bolt is fine. That is fine. Okay, it should be fine for now.
These engine mounts are 71 quid. Starter motor was
264.
I mean, that's cheap. The prices that we were quoted was about 300 quid. That's just the start. We had new engine that closed at 60 quid. We need the rest.
Next to it, you need it moving this way, yeah, to it. to it and just deal with it straight in there, but the rubber things hold it like blades, check it out.
So get that off first. Get these off first and then jack it.
No, you need to jack it. It'll jack straight up.
Have a look. Yeah, the whole chassis is going up. It's still attached to the chassis, then bolts have to come off first.
Yeah, but it's not attached to the engine, it's just the rubber and the metal on this.
Yeah, they go through and then they go into the...
Yeah, and that goes into the chassis. That bolt is what holds it to the engine. So it's not attached to the engine. But the engine's still going up with the chassis.
Can't see it. We're in one of the drawers, I think the bottom drawer, the little toolbox.
That's freedom.
Is it?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's freedom. Yeah, it's fine. There's wood in there. Right, that just needs knocking on there.
We got a hammer, please, Stefan. Don't worry about the bars, just hammer, please. Bars as well. Nice one. I'll take that
off. Too much vibration.
Say when?
About 10 minutes.
You're my eyes up top. No, we're off again. Alright. See if you can bring the end over.
Oh no. anxiety creeps up on me. Is this how it's supposed to feel? Tell me when it's over, I got someplace that I gotta be. It won't leave. My friends say, get out of your comfort zone, it's a blessing in disguise. Get out of what you call home, your name is written in the sky. It might feel just like you're on your own, but baby, it's another lie. Remember you were me. I try to fly.
With you. need that back though.
Think you're slacking it off and it's not.
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
Again.
Don't know how far down this yet we are.
Nope. You ready? Stefan's doing.
Stefan, your turn.
Set those bricks if you want something clean to set.
Shove all that into the top of the block. You got it? Yeah, get back into it.
That's it. He's undoing.
What the fuck is it? You know what we're putting through? Rust. Red oxide.
Deal with now.
not fucking miss.
Yep. We get flatter 2 rod trolls. Medium sized one.
That's not a bad thing actually. It means you must be wedged down.
Yeah, give me. Okay. I am pushing still turning, so I was continuing.
Well, that was easier.
Tried to fill in the cracks that were spreading.
We'd purposely planned.
Yeah, but it probably would have been cool underneath the bus. The other time we'd probably been quite happy under there. Well, can you imagine doing it in the shed, that floor? Oh, that would have been nice.
It would have. Nice concrete floor. Yeah, but the shed would have been boiling, wouldn't it?
No, it stays quite cold,
that's it. It depends. How does the red look then? Yeah, you won't want to know what I use for the red.
It'll look much better if you don't get your dirty hands on it.
You're in back to the red filter.
Hello, it's like council workers, isn't it?
Yeah. Have they just left that caravan there fucked up?
Manchester. Pretty much, aren't we?
Yeah. Oh yeah, we're very near the fucking club.
It adds to the pressure of making this work. It's got to do a motorway trip up there.
If you can do a motorway trip on the back of a recovery truck to Holden, it'll be fine.
Yeah, that's before we took the engine apart. I'll tighten that screw up a bit further again. It's still leaking slightly.
Right.
But it was leaking even less. So I've just nicked it another quarter of a turn.
It's going to be one of those things, slow and steady. Just keep nicking it up. Let it heat up and nick it away.
What's that, the one at the bottom?
No, the injector. Injector 5. Just seeps around the copper washer. But it's been so hot, obviously. All the fuel dry. That's why I checked it. Hopefully it solves the fuel pump issue as well.
So it sounds so much better now, though. Right?
Okay.
Sounds so much better when
it's... Oh yeah, it does. Oh my.
I've done this bit, that's a bit, isn't it?
come back in, let's just see. This engine's been up and down more times than fucking yo-yo.
And you're stood there doing fuck all while they're council worker.
We're supervising. I'm technically not wearing the appropriate PPE.
Yeah, never
mind. Yeah, don't look round our new shop. Self has put this. Mancbuses.com/shop. Yeah, don't look round it.
We've got some
beautiful mugs on sale. Jigsaw puzzle.
I didn't realise you were on sale. So I'd also tell these books weeks, isn't it?
Yeah. Got some mouse mats as well. Got a nice Mancbuses water bottle, plastic, one of the plastic ones, and a stainless steel rubber blankish easy rider on it. Just in case you have a bit of an easy rider, like Scott.
No.
The podcast, however, is not doing very well. Love yourself as a poor guy. The Discord's calmed down a lot. Sean's changed race. He's been sunbathing a bit too much. Sean, just around. How was your work anyway with the temperatures?
I don't even want to talk about that.
Mine was nice that day, come on, mate.
Yeah, also, mate, it weren't too bad. Where I was, there was no aircon. It's an old building. It was nice and cold.
Oh, I had aircon all the way, I just drove around. Nice 18 degrees on the thermostat.
Yeah.
You know, every time you see the stagecoach driving, like a monkey having a bloody heart attack. That's a bit of rust.
That's not rust. Where's the rust in that?
Right. It's a bit of Lancashire just come out of us. Ain't my fault.
She sounds rather cheerful.
Ha 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 ha!
got bits hanging off, got my oil in there, but I'm fine. The oil is boiling, but I'm fine.
That's why Stagecoach runs them. Sorry, did I say that out loud?
I still won't forget that day we pulled off the motorway with 317.
Oh, I'm boiling. Hear it gargling at the front.
We opened the cap and the actual oil was physically simmering.
Wow.
It was hot. Didn't need any more oil in it though. Just put water, let it cool down, put water in it, and it just went again.
And I lost the fucking thing.
These engines are
solid. Bulletproof, aren't they?
I'm waiting to be banned off TikTok for calling an engine bomb proof. There's someone blamed the hot air, the hot weather yesterday, for a Trident starting to burn oil.
What?
Starting to smoke out the exhaust. So alright, there's some other guy who had the Vauxhall Astra. It was on fire as he passed it, right? And the tagline was, this is what happens if you've got a 1.2 or 1.4 car in this heating. Catches fire. It overheats and catches fire if it's 1.2 or 1.4.
You know something? I've used mine throughout this heat wave. Perfectly fine. My coolant's been topped up and I know my fit radiator. Fine.
But it's amazing, isn't it? All these other countries have 1.2 litre cars and they don't spontaneously combust. I love TikTok for the know it alls on it, it's great.
Right, there's that side done. Please just go straight in.
That's what she said.
There we go. That's the time.
Oh, baby.
That's the promotional part.
And the second one. There we are, that's a great hold. Oh, the tight. Oh, fucking hell.
That's your son's gone.
Oh. There we are, finger tight. Let's get the toys out.
Perfect song as well, isn't it?
Don't mind me fondling my butts.
We're supervising the fondling.
Making sure it's not being too rigorous.
It's like the whole new meaning to doggy, doesn't it? Quiet, the starter was fucking loud in the car.
Part when all the managers are fucking off.
He's definitely getting that A1.
Yeah. He likes it up a bit.
I feel like we've been driving an A1.
Fucking woman's car.
It had a splutter the other day when it started this. It didn't splutter today.
Oh no, it just started, didn't it?
Could be anything. Right.
I think it's the first time I've heard it start straight away.
It does when you remember to put the fuel pump on. I've done that a few times, forgot to turn the fuel pump on. Oh, someone commented about the fuel pump, Fury. I apparently we need a new solenoid for the fuel pump. But I'll let Stefan, he's a mechanically minded, guess why we don't need a new solenoid for the fuel pump.
Don't need one.
There you go.
Because the solenoid works, otherwise the fuel pump won't come on. The wiring's all good, it's just the input output from the ladder.
What?
Hold on,
man. Hold on.
All doesn't line up.
Did you put it all in the right holes?
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, true, true.
I hate to be bothered by that one.
We lost monetization on this anyway because of the music.
Oh, the music, yeah.
I don't think I could work in silence in this now.
Oh,
Yeah. 6 feet from the stumps, that one.
It was awake a minute ago.
No. No. No.
Is that what she said? No, 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 no. Hold on a minute. Hold on. Don't finish yet. Viewers at home, this is a fantastic view you've got here. In 5.1 surround sound. You can just see hands.
Ah! That fuel tank's fucking sharp. I can't get the last one in the old Jordan.
Ah, oh, for fuck's
sake. Which one? The one at the...
This. Oh, watch out. Watch out, Stefan, this one.
You might be best off tying up the ones you've got. Then you might be able to get the last one in.
Hmm.
Might just give you a bit extra room. Found a face then. It was the engine, but it found a face apparently.
It's because the engine's alive, it lives. Only just.
It does now thanks to your dad. Weren't doing much living before that point.
Stefan?
Yeah.
See that silver nut?
Yeah.
You throw it on my bolt? I'm out of it.
Oh, some description?
Now, it's a magic wand.
Nope, we've been told it's a magic wand.
Nope, this is tight. It's as tight as that's going.
Must have a little bit of a gap for it.
There's not much of a gap.
It might go a bit further, but it might need a bigger bar. See how it is once it's running.
Well, I had to say, who fits me?
The ultimate. If what? These two pipes weren't here, I reckon I'd be able to please crouch up in it.
Please!
Very good.
Please!
The ultimate, if that one weren't there, I'd be able to climb inside.
That's the air cut. The...
You can now find us on Facebook, YouTube, Patreon, Twitter, and Instagram. Hashtag Mancbuses. Find us at mancbuses.com. Mancbuses, we're sorting scrap.